This is an AHAM Recordings presentation.
I am a DJ.
Well, well. It's that dancing-ass nigga that you see in the club.
That dancing-ass nigga
make you laugh when you buzz.
That dancing-ass nigga
that you got fucked up.
That dancing-ass nigga
that'll get your girls sprung.
All straight hundreds, none of them ones.
Mr. Ooh gets us, cause that's how it's done.
Coming off the dome, straight from Acres home. That's where I come from, that's where I roam.
My YouTube fans, my Facebook fans, it's your girl, Tonya T. I'm back in the Pigpen show. Like I always do it, that's what's up. You know how we do it here at the Pigpen show? We produce hot tracks. We got interviews for you. We got it all. So thanks a lot for your likes, for following us. We really appreciate it, you know. Well, guess what? I got something very special for you today. The legendary Jaime, a.k.a. Bradshaw.
She made this sound like it means something.
Oh, definitely. It means a lot.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
And we're so excited to have you here. What we would say, the official legendary producer of the Screwed Up Quick.
Oh,
I mean, that's what's up,
school,
you know?
For DJ Screw, you know what I'm saying? For real.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So, you know, it's very exciting to have you here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're legendary. It's so much that the fans, your fans, want to know about you. So that's why we got you in the hot seat today.
In the hot seat. I feel it burning already. You know what I'm talking about? Man, really, I feel
good. Exactly. Real
cool. I really like, you know, I wanted to be on the show knowing that I know the origin from, where it come from, and how y'all put it together. And it's so awesome to see y'all teaming up like this and doing what y'all have to do to make this thing happen. And I applaud y'all for sure.
Well, thank you very much. Most definitely appreciate that, you know. We love to show love, you know what I'm saying? H-Town, let everybody know what's going down, how we do it, you know. So, you know, get ready because you're in the hot seat. So, you know, I got some questions for you.
Okay.
And what I'll be doing is, you know, asking you questions that your fans want to know because you're legendary, you know. You started it all, you know, from my research that I've done on you and listening to your music, what you got going on now. So I have a lot of questions, you know. But being in the hot seat, I always start off with my very first question. What I want to know is about your history. So will you tell us how it all started? You know, when did you fall in love with rap? You know, and the music and everything. Just give us a little insight into that.
Well, coming from the M-Town, born in Mississippi in the Delta, coming from the M-Town, Memphis, and then coming to Houston, I already had the soul in me when I got here. So when I got here, what Houston did for me, they molded me into where I, you know, I am able to be right now. That's all through, you know, God network and how he do things. So I was able to be, you know, homed in here and brought to the realization that I had to cross the soul music with what the underground was doing, because they the one making the bread and they the one making things happen and they the one representing Houston. So rap came immediately in my spirit to do.
Right. Yeah. So you was kind of just, it was born into you. Right.
As soon as I touched down and I seen what was happening, you know, when I did my first record, which was more geared to mature hip-hop, you know, when you're talking about Force MDs and you're talking about the Full Force, and then it was a group right out of Field Ward, me coming from Maker's Home,
mm-hmm.
and then it was another group coming out of Field Ward, It had Raheem, Sir Rap-A-Lot, Jukebox, a few other people, and they was called the Ghetto Boys.
Yes.
And when they came out with Car Freaks, we came out at near the same time.
You took us all the way back. You know, I remember all of that. How exciting. What an exciting time that was. Rap was really different.
I remember when they couldn't get in the club, you know, these guys, you know, people just playing their music and my music. And, you know, they actually couldn't actually get in the club. I remember those times.
Right.
You know, because they did not take Houston hip hop, you know, serious, you know, but right, us being R&B, we can come in, you know what I mean, but they did not take Houston rap hip-hop serious, so, you know, it was, I remember those days.
Right.
To come and see it right here, it's just, you know, it's an awesome thing to see it evolve, you know, almost 30 years, and look up and see your little Kikis and Scarfaces done came up and Flips and Kurt Cobain.
Yeah.
You know, just different ones is coming up, you know. It's awesome feeling, you know. Awesome feeling.
Well, that's great. You know, that really gave us a great insight, you right. know. As a fan, you know, we know a lot of stuff about you.
Right.
And you're quite famous here in Houston, definitely. So
I praise him for that.
He's worthy. Well, what we want to know now is, you know, tell us about the Screwed Up Clique, you know, because we know that you're affiliated, we know you did some business, you know, you did some things. That's basically, you know, you was already known in Acres Home, mm-hmm, you know what I'm mm-hmm. saying, because that's where you're from, you know. That's where I'm from.
That's where I'm from.
We'll get into that.
That's where I'm wrong. Talking about. Yeah.
But tell us about the Screwed Up Clique and how that all came about.
Well, a lot of people don't know this, is that I am actually one of the first, you know, members that was officially inducted in 99 by school, you know, to the Screwed Up Clique at that time, because like North Side and South Side didn't get along as well, you know.
Right, and that's what's going on.
I ended up, for some reason, God put me in the right place with C-Note, who was Botany. He's the head of Botany Big Shot Records, and he's the truth, you know what I'm saying? And when I got to him and he heard my tracks, and he said, "You good at these remakes." So he traded us a verse for me to do a song for him, you know, and it was for free, you know, and I didn't mind because, you know, the guy already was, you know, he the one on that famed song saying, in the South Side, we be rolling helicopters about to land in the clover. So he was like, "Oh, man," like, "this boy is the man," you know. So I ended up, he asked me to do a song, and, you know, he said, "I need the written all over your face, and I need it to sound like this, diamonds all in your face." And after that, I did that, and, you know, of course, you know, other things was born from that.
Exactly.
I was in the dope. And then that's when I went on with the, you know, hardest pitting the letter, roll up a blind, knocking pictures out of the wall. This list goes on. And I just thank God for even, you know, having Ronnie Thomas to, you know, introduce me to, you know, C-Note, who the people is from Bryan, Texas, and College Station. That's how I met him. And now just going down there working, you know.
Right.
So, and it was love. You know, it's been love ever since. Love it. I love the ride. Wouldn't take nothing I wouldn't change it for nothing in the world.
Well, that's awesome. You know, it's just incredible, you know, sitting here listening to your history. You know, every song that you mentioned, I've heard, and of course, you know, the fans have heard these songs too.
Right.
And that's basically what put you on the map, you
right.
know.
Yes.
How exciting, you know. Yes. I can imagine, you know, how that was for you, that time of your life.
Yes.
You know, it was like a goal that, you know, you've always wanted to reach. And,
right.
you know, everyone that does music or have a passion,
right.
you know, they have a point to where, you know, they want to get to this certain point. And
right.
you did that, you
right.
know.
Right.
And
sure.
so it's really exciting,
right.
you know. That's why I was really excited about having you here,
okay.
you know. Just to hear about the experience,
right.
you know.
Right.
you offered a lot to Houston, you right. know. You want to tell us, you know, about the ending of the Screwed Up Click or how that all kind of finalized?
I can honestly, I'm always going to keep it real because this is what I was born into. And I was born into music. Me and my father did work with Stax Records, you know, Al Green and some of the best, A&R, some of the best projects, and did raw work with Barcade. I can honestly say that seeing what I have seen in the Houston music market has tainted my heart, because I know that if we would have handled things in a whole nother avenue, or where we really actually kept it a bun, we would be much further in Houston as we, you know, than we are. We had some of the most talented people you ever met in your life. I've been to so many cities across the United States, and I've never heard some of the product that I've heard out of Houston on independent market on through. It's the biggest independent market globally ever. This is the biggest buying rap market ever.
Right.
But the problem is, I can see that everybody takes our style and they through the roof. And the reason why, because they're willing to put more into the product as opposed to take more out to make something else shine instead of the product shine. And it's a deep thing to talk about, but when you look at the history of how we went up and down like a roller coaster, you can honestly understand. I can tell people that a lot of the royalties that I'm about to receive through the suit was given to Johnny and Johnny Dang.
Wow, okay. Instead of,
you know, to the studio time and the music and making it. And I like to tell people, you know, I'm not a nobody, but I feel like I'm the sound that the town forgot.
Right, exactly.
I really feel that I have to say that I am the sound that the town forgot. And when you look at all the 17, 18 consecutive hits that allowed them to receive deals, and once the deals are done, the rest of the albums, they won't even come see you. And here you is, the one that helped them get to that point. It tends to make you bitter if you don't watch out or return back to the vomit, which you don't want to do, or you grind. So I decided to keep grinding.
Right, right. And, you know, I think that's the focus that we all need to do.
Right,
you know,
right.
If you have a dream, just stay focused and keep grinding.
Right.
You know? And you mentioned the sign of the time, you know,
yes.
The sound of the time,
right,
basically,
right,
is what you did.
Right.
So, you know, we want to give you guys a little taste. You know, he mentions the song. So we're just going to, you know, play a little snippet of it just to bring you back to memory, okay? Check it out.
With me as I infiltrate your noggin, I'm to the point in mind boggling, keep it throbbing. If you swing, I'm barbin', even if I'm dubbed like Marvin. I own a dope corner in my jar, niggas are starving.
Mind blowing big, sipping on a daily basis. Quick to hop out on your block and big faces, then slamming open spaces, looking good and standing tall. Be by your block, knocking pictures off your wall. Riding, blowing big, sipping on a daily basis. Quick to hop out on your block and big faces, then slamming open spaces, looking good and standing tall. Be by your block, knocking pictures off your wall. Running for real, flipping laces to see.
Diamonds all in your face. On third.
Just shine, just shine, just shine, just shine for me.
We're rolling 20s on the bird.
I'm hooked like handcuffs. A thrust and a head rush says that I've had enough. I'm sprung, here it comes, down the pathway through my lungs. A cloud of colored smoke blends with my oxygen. No one human being can give me this satisfaction. Your centripetal force causes a chain reaction. The strategy you use is addictive to many. One of you is not enough, I need 5 for 20. I smoke plenty, menage a trois with cigars. Rapping weed like a gauze puts my mind on Mars.
Hey, that's what's up.
What's up? What's
man,
up?
That was a trip down memory lane. Back down memory lane. You know, we all can relate to those songs. We all remember those songs. You know, what was going on. You know, what we were doing. It just takes us back to a good time, a good place,
appreciate,
you know.
Appreciate
it. When rap was genuine.
Genuine.
Everybody was just digging it, you know what I'm saying?
It was what's
and
up.
You definitely put your place on the map as far as rap is concerned, you know.
It
was great, you know. You want to tell me a little bit about your experience?
That right there, like, I mean, to sum it up in a nutshell, you know, God took me from being a fiend, I can say, took me back to being a king. Went through a lot of things in the younger years of my life, and to find myself from coming out of the gutter, out of Acres home, you know, been through some trying times, and to come off of Dolly Wright and Carver, you know what I'm saying, out of humble beginnings,
man,
to be able to, you know, see my stepfather, you know, who has, man, you know, this man right here has given me, you know, a second breath in life, to him saying, you know, man, you did it, you dreamed about it, and all you did, all you used to do is music, I mean, you know, people laughed about you, you know, people joked. You know, people wonder why I let you stay here and you ain't working. But in the all in all, you done it.
And it all paid off.
Wow. Like, man, knock me off. That's better than money. You know, yes. It's better than money. So, you know.
Well, that's what we do it for, you know, loving music.
Love
you
it.
Know.
Love it. I can tell you love it.
Right,
it's in your bones. That's why I couldn't. I actually begged to work with this lady. Yes, I had to go through my partner, Jose, to get through
the legendary.
We gonna be a beat ass three, but we don't tell it on him. But we did a hit together. We collaborated. I love him to death. And she's an awesome talent too. So, you know, I give you a call.
Thank you.
She got a legendary voice too. So it's already legendary. Get the product. It's legendary when you hear it. For real.
Well, thanks for the love. That's how
we gotta do that. We gotta give it what it do it.
Well, that's what's sad.
For real.
Well, you know, what we love to do is we have different questions. Mm-hmm. And, of course, I'm feeling what your fans want to know. Mm-hmm. And so what we want to know is the present. What's going on right now? Now, the word on the street is that you have a new album that's coming out, mm-hmm. which is overdue.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
We've been waiting.
Right.
So your new hit single on your new album, Let's Stay Together, why don't you tell us about that song? It's a great song, that I know for sure.
Right. That's a song that God gave to me, so I had to give it out for you. I gave it $5. You can get it at Reverb Nation. Download it for free or whatever. You go to YouTube and you download it for free. I didn't want to do the song until I went to the divorce court and seen all the numbers of people just get divorced. So it's God put it in my heart. Release this song right now. Let's
think. We hurt one another for a knowing. If we meant our vows, why don't we show it? Should we stay together?
You know, you have so many great songs on this album, you know. A lot of hits, you know. So, one more hit. I mean, this is a great one. This is the signature of his album.
Mm.
I Came Back, you know.
Wow.
That says a lot, you know. You want to tell us about that? How you came up with the song? you know, the meaning of it, the whole background. Just give us what you want to give us.
I could actually tell you that I want to say this and iterate that, you know, we're blessed by the testimonies we give. And we can actually, I can honestly say that, you know, when I sang that song in the studio, I didn't know it meant that much to me because we had played with it on the boat. You know, we hood helped me put the instrumental on. I just started playing and came up with a hook like I always do with the gold DJ. And just so happened, I said, man, we need to cut. Somebody told me we need to cut it after they put it on their Facebook. So we cut the song. And as I was singing the hooks, and I sung them all by the, you know, in one take, I sung all the hooks to it.
Wow.
I started crying. And the tears was coming out of my eyes. So by the end, toward the end, if you hear, you really listen, you can kind of hear my voice quivering. And I'm actually tears running out of my eyes. And all God showing is me, he brought me from being a dope fiend out of Acres Home, 25 years clean, praise the Lord for that. All and, right. You know, and he want me to show people that, yeah, if your brother or your sister or any family member, you know, if you pray for them and you allow them, you know, to go through what he's doing for them, he said he guaranteed he'll bring them out because I am a living example. So I must say that. And it just, the song just, it penetrated my soul just saying I came back through it all, through the drugs, through the divorce, through the life changes, the financial changes, you know, going from 300 grand a year to barely 30 a year.
Right,
barely,
right.
You know, that's a big drop.
It's a change.
Right, so uh-huh, just the whole thing, you know, and it was my way of expressing myself, you know, losing 130 pounds so far and expressing wow myself and saying, you know, God, you told me you're going to turn my time back, and yeah, I came back. And here I am almost 50, and, you know, a lot of people say I don't look it. So I just thank know God. Thank God. I appreciate you.
Well, it's a great song. It's, I would say, a testimony, you know.
Yes.
It definitely speaks to you. Mm-hmm. When I saw you perform it, it was just amazing how the reaction of wow the club and how everybody was responding, because, you know, it relates to everybody. And you know what? Check it out. We got a little mini video we want to show you of him doing I Came Back. So check it out.
I am DJ.
Well, well.
That dancing ass nigga that you see in the club,
that dancing ass nigga
make you laugh when you buzz,
that dancing ass nigga
that you got fucked up,
that dancing ass nigga
that'll get your girl sprung.
All straight hundreds, none of them ones,
Mr. Ooh gets us, cause that's how it's done.
Coming off the dome, straight from Acres Home, that's where I come from, that's where I roam.
That's what's up, you
that's
know.
Up.
Hey, up. It's going down here at the Pigpen Show.
What my boy?
Hi, me.
Hi.
Interesting.
TNT,
okay.
What's up? About to explode. See, hot too, man.
Well, you know, as our final question, we always want to know, your fans are watching, okay? So if you have something to say to them, they're looking right now. What would you want to say to your fans?
You are the sunshine of my life. No, I just want to say, you know, I really appreciate y'all. You know, the 30 years has been a good road. It's almost 30, and we just blessing, you know, the blessings that God put, the kind of fans that stayed true to any organization I work with. I'm just thankful, and you know, through the bad and the good, it's all working together, you know, to mold what we call Hymie. And I always tell people I built a brand name. My real name is James Bradshaw. But I built a brand name, and the brand name has taken me places that I would never ever imagine. And I thank God for being able to travel all over the United States and receive residuals from all over the world, and be charted on Billboard as many times, be plaqued as many times. I just thank God, little old kid coming out of San Antonio, Mississippi, all the way to Memphis, came to Houston, and now God has blessed me to be able to be in an arena to where I can live forever. So I figure that one day, 50 years from now, when I'm gone, somebody will play Knock the Pictures Off the Wall or some of the great joints that was put out there. And we just appreciate you. Love you. Love everybody. I just want to tell you, keep God first. You can make it no matter what. For real.
I love it so much, man. Yeah, much love.
Thank you. I appreciate you. Awesome.
That was
awesome.
Beautiful, man. Awesome. You know, that was for me. That was for all the fans, you know. Hey, we really appreciate you coming to the Pigpen Show. Thank you so much.
I appreciate you.
This has been anticipating.
Yes. And whenever, it's good to be in the hot seat when you're around such beauty.
Well, thank you very, very much.
That's how we do.
And this is what we love to do in the Pigpen Show. Who's ever in the hot seat, we want to find out about your past, your present, and your future.
Awesome.
Because we're fans, we want to know about you, and I hope that we were informative and everybody got the real Jaime, a.k.a. James Bradshaw.
For life.
Again, welcome, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much.
I like that.
Okay, and remember, don't forget to check us out on YouTube. Go into AM Recordings, and you'll find us under the Pigpen Show, hosted by your girl, Tonya T. One more time, we got Jaime in the hot seat. Check us out, and like I always say, peace.
Reggie Reg.
I just need to do them, huh?
Yeah. Goes out to all my fallen soldiers in the club. First nigga from the north side, inducted in 99. So you still screwed up, click for life. Hey. Like Pat, I got a ghetto dream to be a big hawk, and I'ma spread my wings and become a gun like little Kiki. And every day dancer like ESG. I will lean Big Mo and have them see things I can see notes while I'm on my knee. But you ain't never seen a nigga little flipping in Byzantine. Keep my Glock hot, cause I'm mean like green. Riding so low, slanging, banging on King. Lost a lot of weight, call me Slim Thuggin'. 5,000 watts, where my amp pushing. Knocking pictures off the wall like a youngster on the scene. See my boy Kirk banging with a cup full of lean. Nothing but love when I come down. My nigga got a sound, represent the H-Town. I'm a pimp to the C, a bun to the B. A legendary nigga that's a trill OG. Like Roy, I roll blue like Northside blue. But we don't bang, we bang screw. May see me in the H, chunking up the deuce. JC, Waltz, Ness, and chunking deuces out the roof. Still hang with good fellas like D. Red, real G, stick together when in front the fence. I'ma keep it player, player like Big Mike said. And I'ma keep sending prayers to my fam, mama with. Like Trey, I be the truth. Mike Jones, I say who. Big poking on them crew. Paul Wall, what it do? Big T, make me wanna be a baller. 20-inch blades rolling in the Impala. Steady Billy cooking, I'm a good superstar. As I turn my crumbs to brick, gratefully without a scar. Face my disappointments like Jay. Hate, and I'ma really do you in the face. Staying mellow in this shit, I be chill like Angeline. I be swift with them beats, call me the original beat king. Whoa, don't say acres home can't. As I ride behind 10, J-dogging in the paint. God save me from the street, trap cops be rob my man. Mario from the bricks used to sell me Doja Grams. Man.
the H is so real.
Recordings presentation.